Alright, it's time for more Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. Getting off where I, well, where I left off, I guess. I just beat the Nugget Bridge, and I saw Charmander in the distance, just like the yellow special Pikachu, special version edition, whatever they wanted to call it. So yeah, grabbing Charmander right now. I always started off with Charmander, and even Charmander was my very, very, very first starter. And of course, he went all the way to Charizard. I got him to like level 70 or something. And, you know, looking back with the actual moves and everything, I think Venusaur is an actually more balanced and strategical starter. But just, you know, you can't beat owning a dragon. And of course, this is the infamous trainer, I saw your feet from the grass. And people were like, oh, they spelled feet wrong, but it meant feet as in like accomplishment, not feet as in the things on the bottom of your legs. Oh yeah, and then I totally forgot to check this building to the west of the Pokemon Center. Because of course, they have a Bulbasaur. Just like the yellow special Pikachu version edition or whatevs. So I got my Charmander. And then talked to this lady. Well, she, in the first, or the original yellow special Pikachu edition, she, I guess she like, checks to see if you're friendly enough with your Pikachu, or if the friendship's good enough or something. But in this one, she just asks if you caught enough Pokemon, and then you get Bulbasaur that way. But I still have Mr. Toad, you know, my Bulbasaur that I got from Viridian Forest. I think, you know, comparing them and everything, I just ended up going with Mr. Toad. Anyway, sticking with Mr. Toad, putting that rescue Bulbasaur back in my Pokemon box, and then continuing the adventure northeast, a Cerulean City, Route 25. Can't start off with Magikarp, though. Use my Mr. Toad. You know, I think I'm just gonna evolve Bulbasaur, or should I say Mr. Toad. Cause I don't know how long it's gonna take to get Razor Leaf, and Vine Whip's doing fine for right now. I'm already like super powered, super over leveled. So if you remember, this trainer up here to the east, this was the one that you battled to do that Mew glitch. But I seriously doubt you can do the Mew glitch or anything like that in this game, because you would have to pause and go to that main menu, like right before a trainer sees you, and then fly away. And then that like kind of activates the glitch or something, and then you go to a trainer and have them walk towards you. That's when you go to this trainer. But it's not like even that many trainers walk towards you. I don't even know who figured out that glitch, man. Thank you. And then for this trainer, you gotta make sure he actually comes towards you, because if he doesn't, then you're gonna have to come later on, cut down that little bush to get that item, which happens to be a technical machine.
Thank you.
Sea Cottage. Bill lives here. The Pokemaniac. In the anime, they make it look like he lives at a lighthouse. A date spot? Yeah, also in, I think it was Fire Red and Leaf Green. Or was it Heart Gold and Soul Silver? One of those games, you actually come across Misty at this, like, date spot. And she was on a date with some dude. And then she's like, what the heck, man? You, like, totally blow up my spot. And then that's when you challenge her to a battle at the Pokemon Gym or whatevs. Did I just get seismic tossed into CIA headquarters? Wait, what the heck? I don't even remember seeing this when I was playing it the first time. Pika support? And now let's go visit Bill on a seaside cottage. So I wasn't too sure how they were gonna like play this out with the 3D models and everything, because you know, the original sprites, he just looked like the monster design, and then in the anime he was just in a suit of a Kabuto or whatever. But yeah, anyways, this is how it went. And that is what they turned Bill into. Some square-jawed, jock-looking motherfucker. I don't even know. I mean, because he's supposed to be like this nerdy Pokemon maniac. And, you know, always studying Pokemon in a seaside cottage alone. But now, look at this. It's like Beast from Beauty and the Beast when he becomes human. He's like, what? And my friend Amanda, she's like, oh, Tumblr's gonna have a field day with this. So you see that little icon on the bottom left hand corner of the screen? I thought it was like a save icon and I was like trying to find an Easter egg or something. But actually you're supposed to shake your Joy-Con to go directly to your partner Pokemon. Instead of like pausing, going to the main menu, and then going to play with your partner Pokemon. So since I didn't really find out until then, I shook it again and I saw that Pikachu had a present for me. A shard of glass. Thanks, Pikachu. That's pretty much the end of this video, Roots 24, 25. Subscribe to see my next video in Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu series. Gonna be taking on Cerulean City Gym and the gym leader Misty for the, what was it? Cascade Badge. I wonder what kind of attack she's gonna have, cause normally she had Bubble Beam, but Brock normally had Bide and this time he had Headbutt or whatever. What is it, Charmeleon? I almost said Charmander. Silver Raspberry. Alright, anyways, end video. See you guys later.